this time we are testing the IP67 rated Samsung Galaxy A53 5G, one of the newest A series 5G devices launched recently. We will also be covering some of the other A series devices later in the coming weeks. A 32 megapixel f2.2 wide angle selfie camera on the Super AMOLED, a 64 megapixel Sony IMX682 primary sensor, 12 megapixel ultra wide lens, and 5 megapixel f2.2 lens each for depth and macro shots. We are performing the scratch test to know the scratch resistance capabilities of the tempered glass protection by rubbing it with items like an old bottle opener and a tried and trusted steel blade, which gives the most accurate measurement with proof of marks and scratches compared to every other tool. The good news is we have hardly had a Samsung fail a blade abuse due to use of genuine Corning glass protection, unlike some budget BBK and Realme devices failing the blade on a consistent basis. As expected of high quality Corning Glass 5 production, the Samsung A53 5G easily passes a scratch test. Next, on to the liquid damage resistance and water test. It's absolutely awesome to get an official IP67 rating on a mid-ranger like the Galaxy A53 5G, more so since the previous generation did not have it. We will be dropping and deep freezing the A53 for more than 2 hours. But before that, let's finish with the first round of olefobic bar testing. Samsung has never compromised in this area in any of the devices compared to Realme and BBK, who consistently cost cut. You can see the olefobic proof by the way the water flows over the glass surface, almost in a repulsive fashion. We are directly skipping onto the heavy drenching round, taking for granted that light splashing is not at all going to affect the A53 owing to the official IP67 certification. The audio level and volume from the external stereo speakers is also very stable and undistorted at this stage, a clear sign of proper water resistance. All the heavy drenching abuse does not seem to make an iota of difference to the Galaxy A53 5G. So moving on to the more than 2 hours underwater freeze test. Starting the timer and dropping the A53 5G underwater, let's see what happens. We will be keeping the music playing on the A53 throughout the test to check for any signs of initial liquid damage. But right now, the sound is slightly audible even underwater. We have mostly tested Samsung flagships with IP68 ratings, but very few IP67 devices, though it never had much liquid trouble with it anyways. IP67 always seems to be as good as IP68. I guess this will be the first time we will be testing an IP67 device for more than 2 hours underwater in deep freezing conditions, and we are presuming that it should be able to handle the freeze abuse. Okay, so let it marinate and rot underwater in the freezing cold, and we'll see for sure if the IP67 is able to sustain the cold abuse or not. After the 2 hour mark, things seem to be fine. The display and low music is still on, and no signs of any sort of internal damage until now. We will leave it in this condition for about 30 minutes more.
Tomorrow for sure. 2,000 years later. 12 seconds later.
A slight bit of worry since the AMOLED display has finally gone off after staying on for 2 hours. The music also seems to have died out. After more than 2 hours and 30 minutes of freezing cold, the Samsung Galaxy A53 5G feels like a cold block of frozen ice. But thankfully, the display did turn on after the initial scare. The touchscreen is not very responsive as of now, though that was just a temporary issue due to the shock of water and ice. The audio eventually made a full comeback after a few minutes of recovery. The A53 5G passes a 2-hour underwater freeze test with ease, 0% damage sustained. Next, on to fun stuff with value and the moment of truth of build quality, the bend test. Is the nightmare, soft and weak build of the previous A series behind us? Has Samsung improved upon the poorly designed build quality? There is a definite bit of flex from the first AMOLED side bend and a clear cracking sound from the underside, which seems to be harmless as of now. The backside bend also has some degree of flex, but the A53 5G still is able to handle the immense force. The bend degree is mostly concentrated towards the top half of the plastic body and midframe, and thankfully, the cracking sound was only a false alarm. It was more of a clamp getting out of place rather than the plastic midframe breaking. The Samsung Galaxy A53 5G passes the bend test due to an improved plastic design.